Computer viruses can come from anywhere. That's why it's important to be careful with what you download on the internet. When I first started using Blender, the Blender community was relatively safe from this, with long-standing products and reputable sites. But that's changing every day with more malware attacks, even against the Super Hive Market, other Blend file sharing sites, but awareness isn't always enough. So let me show you some tips to protect you from malicious attacks within the Blender community. The first tip is for those that use Windows. Let me show you four files. Can you tell the difference between these two and these two? The thing is, one of these is a Blend file, while the other is not. Same thing goes with zip files. This is a zip file, but this one is not. So while this details pane shares the file type, you can't really tell just from looking at the names what type of file it is. Executable files can have their own custom icon, and there's ways to be able to change the icon to look like something it's not. Windows hides the file extension by default, which frankly I think is a little ridiculous. But in Windows 11, you can use View, Show, and File Name extensions. Now you can see this one is a .blend file, this one's .exe for executable, and this one is a .zip file. So with this on, you should be able to tell quickly of whether something is actually a Blend file, an executable, or a zip file. Now, just because you have a Blend file doesn't mean it's actually safe. So if I go to a test file that I have, you'll notice, thankfully, Blender will say, hey, there's a Python script that is set to auto-run upon opening. Do you want it to be allowed, or do you want to ignore it? And so I'll ignore it, so we don't get this super suspicious library being imported. If you wonder how that's set up, if you go into your text editor for scripting, you go into scripting workspace, and there's an option for register. This means to run the script on loading the file. Now, Blender has auto run off by default, and so that's why it has that prompt. If you're wondering, why on earth would I ever let a script auto run? The difference is that in some cases, especially with animators and riggers, sometimes they have a custom script to be able to give them an extra panel of controls for the rig. This can be great for streamlining the animation process. But of course, you wouldn't want to do this with files you don't trust. So if you ever want to tinker with this setting, you go to Edit, Preferences, Save and Load, there's Auto Run Python scripts. If you want to have the option to auto run these scripts, then you would check it. But if you do want to auto run scripts, I would highly recommend excluding some paths where you know you wouldn't be running files you trust. For example, the downloads folder. So I'll just do that here. Do download selected. There's also this little hidden arrow when you'd use the file browser, whenever you're setting a file path in Blender. You click that and we'll uncheck relative path. So that way it uses the absolute path of your download folder and not just the path relative to whatever Blend file you're currently using. But if you've never needed to run a script automatically, then I'd say just keep it off by default. And if you worry about checking this on or off all the time, because there's cases where you do want to be running scripts, but there's other times when you don't, you can also force it on or off in a terminal or in your Windows shortcut. So let's say we want a shortcut. So this is a brand new shortcut. I can just right-click it, Properties. Notice there's this target that's highlighted. This basically just says, go to this file. And so what we can do is we can add a flag that you can also use in a terminal, but it works perfectly fine. A shortcut here is add a flag to disable the auto execute. In this case, we just add a space, then dash dash disable dash auto exec. I'll link in the description of all the possible commands you can use for the terminal or in a shortcut, but this forces it off. So that way, no matter what you have it set in Blender for this session, when you run the shortcut, it'll force it off. And you can also force it on with enable autoexec, just like that. But when in doubt, keep that setting off whenever reasonable, and always, always, always double check this. If it's something you don't trust, just ignore. If you ever change your mind and want to run it, then you can just click the play button in the script editor. Quick short video, but I figured it was relevant, so I wanted to make sure this got out there. Hopefully these few tips help protect yourself and others. So happy, safe blending.